Good morning, everybody. I am here for story time. Why am I holding two turkey feathers? Am I Native American Indian? No. Family always thought we were. We thought we had it built on both sides. But it turns out that my grandmother was Asian and India Indian, not Native American Indian. However, before I did my genetic testing, I hear Aja over here. Before I did my genetic testing, I always thought that it was Native American Indian, which did prompt me into the research into a lot of different animals and their symbolism. But one important thing that the turkey feather teaches is that all life is sacred. And so before I begin my story, I wanted to say that because in every story, we want the hero or the heroine to win out. You know, we always want them to beat the bad guy, you know, serve up the villain some justice. But just knowing that turkey teaches us all life is sacred is without these villains, we wouldn't have heroes in the story. And I learned this too through the process of how they would transport salmon across country. So let's say we're going from West Coast to East Coast, delivering some salmon. So they would take the salmon frozen and deliver it to the East Coast. But they were finding out by the time it came and in a frozen state, it would really lose its flavor. So they said, how can we make this salmon taste fresher for everyone? So then they decided, well, let's keep the salmon alive. We'll put it in some tanks of water and send it across the country still fresh. And they realized that that increased its flavor a lot, but it still didn't have that wild salmon taste. So this genius of a man decided, hey, let's transport the salmon with the natural enemy in its tank. Because whatever the enemy that the salmon had in the wild, I forget the name of that fish, but that would actually cause it, the salmon, to produce this something in its system, release something in its system that it would make it way more flavorful. So by the time it got to the East Coast, they tasted it exactly the way they tasted on the West Coast. So I think without our enemies in the tank, so to speak, in our life, we don't have that flavorfulness, that character building, you know, without Haman, you know, there can't be the Mordecai and Esther, you know, Judas selling Christ out for the 30 pieces of silver. I mean, it couldn't have led him to the cross and the victory. So there's always some villain lurking in the background, but it's very purposeful. And I think in our spiritual walks, this is the truth. Some of us have really, we have been in the salmon tank, but we've been in there with tons of our enemies, maybe, so to speak. It feels like at times. But so I want to share a story from a book I had written several years back. Here is the book, God's Presence in Every Season and Situation. And it really feels like fall today. I woke up, fall is in the air. As a matter of fact, I put on my slow cooker, it seemed like fall today. Now this story is from October, several years back. And I know it's not October, it's only September. I'm kind of jumping the gun here. It's just that it reminded me of that time of year because as the season starts to change and the leaves are falling, this is sort of what this is about. So I'm just gonna read it straight from the book. Sometimes marriages can go through difficult times, and this was one of those rough patches. All I had was my faith in God as I was trapped in a hopeless marriage. During my prayer time concerning this difficult relationship, I sought God. I was led by the Holy Spirit to pray for my spouse for the next 30 days. Being autumn, there were tons of beautiful leaves in various colors on the trees and on the ground. I chose a leaf for each day of that month. I would write a prayer or concern on it for my husband, things like peace in his heart, forgiveness for others, mercy in his life, and joy of spirit. Each day it continued. I faithfully gathered the leaves and excitedly placed them in a brown paper bag. At the end of the 30 days, I wanted to let the leaves gently fall over his head, like all the prayers falling on him like blessings. I thought it would bring my spouse comfort knowing I was praying for him daily. Instead, I got cussed out and told that if I was a man, he would have punched me in the face. After explaining everything, I thought he would soften and be more receptive. He grew angrier, saying that he clearly was not the one in need of prayer and that it was an act of assault. I was hurt so badly by his response. I actually went into my room and cried. I mean, I was bawling. I was crying. I was a baby. And when I was done crying, I remember feeling confused and a bit angry. And I was actually kind of, I hate to admit this, I was angry at the Lord. I'm like, Lord, you told me to pray for him. Like, I really had attitude. Like, I got attitude with Yahweh. That's pretty insane. Anyway, I said, you told me to pray for him for 30 days. And his response was, I did, but I didn't tell you that he would be receptive. I only asked for your obedience. Slap, snap. Ugh, that hit me. I learned a valuable lesson in this. Sometimes all our efforts and best intentions aren't met how we hope they would be met. We can't control a person's responses and shouldn't want to. We can only control whether we are obedient to God and choose to walk by faith and love. We cannot make them respond with love or gratefulness. Sometimes the Lord asks us to do things to test our obedience and self-discipline. I had known for some time already that my husband was suffering with bitterness, anger, and hatred, but the Lord was showing me more. I continued to pray for him, and like the leaves, I continued to let go and let God. And I put a little PS in a Bible verse in my story because I tend to do that. And actually all the stories in this book have a PS and a Bible verse. So PS, although others may not always accept your grace, mercy, and love, God, I accept and thank you for your leaves of blessing that you shower over me. And the Bible verse is from Luke 6, 27 and 28. But to you who are listening, I say, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, and pray for those who mistreat you. Whew, I just felt the sun come out. Super bright. Yes, thank you, Lord. So one of the things that I've done throughout my life is, besides finding meaning in different animals, is also finding meaning in numbers. And the fact that the Lord had asked me to specifically do 30 days is kind of interesting. So in my little Troy Brewer book of numbers, it talks about in chapter 30, it talks about the number 30, and it says that when there is a kingdom venture, when heaven is beginning to transform the earth, God likes to stamp the number 30 on it. When somebody is serving the Lord in a very significant way, God seems to stamp the number 30 on it. So the prime age of the priests, like when they would finally come into their full duties in the priests in Leviticus was 30 years. And also King David began to reign over Israel when he was 30 years old, and Jesus didn't enter his ministry and get baptized until he was 30 years old. So 30 is definitely a significant number. And even the price of a female servant during her prime was 30 pieces of silver. So, and the prophet Ezekiel, he began his book in the 30th year, which is probably a reference to his age. So, and then that leads us back to Judas betraying Jesus for 30 silver coins. So I am no longer with this man due to Holy Spirit's guidance. I got out of a very dangerous situation. And that's another reason why I brought these Cherokee feathers, because I'm not getting on here to down talk him as a person, because as Turkey teaches us, all life is sacred. So his life is sacred too in God's eyes. And without that, there would be a part of my life, an aspect of my testimony, you know, that would go unsaid. And I think that I just want to encourage anyone out there, women, men, that are going through a relationship that you know deep down God is not asking you to be in. He wants you out of, there might come this time of testing. God will test your heart, but eventually I think that eventually there are some of you out here, this video may not resonate with everyone because everyone's on a different life path and a different life journey. But for any woman or man out there, if you're sensing that you're not meant to be in this relationship, I think God is asking you to get out and get to Him and get to safety and just continue to pray for those people in your life and that have caused you grief and pain and suffering. So I want you to be blessed by this video, and I will come on again for another story time.